A good 2 years, I think, of and I read an undergraduate immunology textbook, and I met with an immunology professor and sat in on some lectures. I also was just trying to get a basic sense when I was writing this book of what the immune system is and how it works. And it turns out that it's the most complicated and hard to understand system in the body. I'd be better off, you know, trying to understand brain science than immunology. But I did. I think I got the barest understanding in those 2 years, and then I worked from there and was able to then talk to more immunologists further down the line and get deeper knowledge as I worked. There's an entire chapter devoted to germs and why we need germs, and that was a part of immunology that I found totally fascinating, was this long relationship between us and microorganisms and how dependent our health is on microorganisms, and how detrimental it would be to us to, say, for example, you know, totally sanitize our environment, kill all the germs. We're actually we've co-evolved with microorganisms, and we need them, and they need us to some extent too. There's a real symbiosis there. I was speaking with an immunology professor who was talking to me about how no single human has the genetic material to fight every disease, but that collectively we're genetically diverse enough that humans as a whole can't be wiped out by one single disease. So there isn't going to be one disease that will kill the entire human race, because we're so genetically diverse that some of us will always be able to resist whatever it is. And that to me was a beautiful metaphor for, again, the ways that we work as a collective and how dependent we are on other bodies, and how alone we actually can't achieve complete immunity alone, but as a species we can. And that kind of informed, that was an undercurrent of thinking that informed actually the entire book, that idea that a single body can't stand alone against disease, but a collective body can. This book was born out of conversations with other mothers, and in those conversations that I had with other mothers when my son was quite young were very intense conversations around vaccination, but other parenting issues. And this book really was born of that conversation, and that's still an audience that's very important to me in this book, is talking with and to other mothers, and in some ways from my own mother. So the book begins and ends with two different Greek myths. So it begins with the myth of Achilles, and it ends with the myth of Narcissus. And those are myths that my mother read to me when I was a child. And that's one of the ways that my mother kind of speaks through this book, is through the mythology that she trained me in. And also a way of thinking, a kind of stance towards metaphor that she trained me into. My understanding of my writing is that I've always inhabited a kind of hybrid space between genres, and the two genres that I feel like I'm most often straddling are poetry and nonfiction. But even within nonfiction, I end up straddling subgenres. So, like this book, for example, there's a lot of personal narrative, but there's also a lot of research. So, in terms of even categories of nonfiction, I'm moving between them. The one place I've never gone as a writer is fiction, but I also I also don't think it's impossible. I started, while I was writing this book, I was doing all this research on vampires and Dracula, and Dracula is actually a huge presence in this book. And I started kind of dreaming up an idea for a novel that would be a kind of gothic novel. So maybe that will happen someday. I don't know how I would ever do that, but I think that's also how I felt at the beginning of this book. It felt like something I wasn't sure I could actually do.
Thank you.